Welcome back to the MacWhisperer Academy. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the MacWhisperer. And if you're one of those people that is just drowning in email and desperate for a tool that can help you master the madness, then today's video was made just for you. MacMail is an amazing and powerful application, but like most of Apple's stuff, it doesn't come with a manual, so there's no easy way to understand all of the capabilities and all of the tools that you can use. This is part two of our Getting Organized with MacMail video series, and in today's video, we're going to talk about those tools that will make it easier for you to manage your email. If you stick with me until the end of today's episode, I'm going to share with you my number one most requested tip about how to remove addresses that are auto-filling when you're trying to create emails. So let's get right into tip number one, jump over onto the computer and open up MacMail. The first tip is called the filter, and you'll see it up in your toolbar right up here. In its default setting, when you click on the filter, it will show you all the unread messages in whatever mailbox it's pointed to. But that's not all it can do. While it's on, if you press and hold on it, you will open up this secret menu that gives you the ability to isolate specific mailboxes that you might want to filter, or include unread messages versus flagged messages, or messages that are CC'd to you or with attachments or from VIPs. And the best part of this filter is that you can stack the separate things on top of each other. So for example, I'm going to have it show me all of the flagged messages. And now we're down to about 30 items, but I'm going to press on it again. And this time I want things that are flagged and have attachments. And just like that, I can isolate these six items so that I can find them super quickly without having to hunt around. So using the filter properly is critical. I do recommend leaving it on the unread setting because it's really the one you're going to use the most and the one that's the most valuable. But if you do need to find something quickly or something with an attachment or something from a particular account, the filter can be very helpful and very useful for that. Our second tool is called a smart mailbox. Now, the first thing to talk about is when you create a folder on MacMail, it'll show up on the left side over here with this little folder icon. But we don't call them folders, we actually call them mailboxes. And there's two kinds of mailboxes. There's a standard mailbox like this, which gets messages that I drag into it. But there's also something called smart mailboxes. And smart mailboxes can be really, really powerful. Unlike a standard mailbox where you drag things into it, a smart mailbox has its own logic and has its own rules, and it creates its own folder. So what you can do is you can easily create a smart mailbox by coming up here and clicking the plus button, or by coming into the mailbox menu at the top of your screen here and choosing new smart mailbox. When you get a smart mailbox, it's initially going to show you this kind of a screen asking you what kind of information you want in that mailbox. So first off, give it a title, and then you can choose different criteria for it to sort and find those messages. In this case, I'm going to click here and I'm going to choose entire message contains MDI, which is one of the organizations I'm a part of. Now, when I click OK, that smart mailbox is immediately created over on the sidebar with the title I gave it. And it begins to search. In this case, it's found almost 7,000 messages, which is more than I need to find here. So I'm going to right-click on that smart mailbox and come down to edit it, and I'm going to add some additional criteria. I can click the plus button over here to add any sort of thing that I might want. So I'm going to set it as date received is after January 1st, 2023. And add another criteria. In this case, I want to make sure this is something that has an attachment. As you build your smart mailbox, be aware of this setting here. I'm going to click the OK button, and now I'm down to 200 messages from the last year with attachments that have the word MDI in them, and I'm able to filter that down as easily and simply as I want. Now I'm going to talk about tip number three, which is sort of related to smart mailboxes. It's called rules, and here's how it works. First thing I'm going to do is go back to my inbox and I'm going to click on a specific message. Now I'm going to come into the mail menu here and open up settings, which you can also do by pressing command and comma. As the settings come up, I'm going to move over to the rules section here and I'm going to add a new rule. Notice that because I had already clicked on an email, it brought that email address right into the rule, so it's easy for me to set it up. It's a little shortcut that makes it easier to build these rules. We're going to call this rule news. And in this news rule, what I want to do is when it matches that address or any other address that I add from here using the any statement, I can automatically have it set the background color of that message so it's easier for me to see. This is a great way to isolate or identify specific messages, but the rules capability is vast. You can add additional criteria by clicking the plus button here, or additional actions by clicking here. And the actions can be all sorts of things, from moving a message into a specific folder, to playing a sound, or creating a notification, or even running an Apple script, which is a tiny program that can do almost anything. In this case, I'm just going to keep it simple and let it color the news from medium. So I'm going to click OK. I'm going to go ahead and apply it. And what you'll notice is immediately the medium daily digest shows up in that color. So it's an easy way to automate some of the processes, some of the filing, and some of the organization of your email. The next tip is your VIP section. You should see your VIPs on your favorite section on the left sidebar here. Here's how you create a VIP. First, you're going to come to any message and you're going to go to the address section, and to the left of the person's name, you're going to notice a little star. Clicking that star will immediately add that person as a VIP. There's two reasons to add someone as a VIP. The first one is so that you can quickly and easily find their messages at will. The VIP section will show messages that are in your inbox from any of these specific addresses, so you don't have to hunt around for a recent message. You can see it right here. But there's another functionality to the VIPs that is really important, and that's the ability to customize your notifications. So I'm going to go into the mail menu here and go into settings, but this time I'm going to come over to the general section. In the general section, you'll notice this new message notifications. This means that you can control when a new message comes in, how it notifies you. Now, I'm not a big fan of being notified about emails because I get so much junk. But being notified about emails from my VIPs, that's helpful. And that's the power of having your VIP section and setting it up properly. If you have people on the VIP list that you don't want, it's very easy to just highlight them and right-click and choose Remove from VIPs, and they will disappear. It won't remove any of their emails, it'll just remove them from the VIPs list. Keep your VIP list short and sweet with people that you're currently working with so that you can easily click one button and see exactly what they've sent you without having to hunt for it. So we're going to create a signature very easily by coming into the mail menu and opening up settings, and this time hopping over to the signature page. Creating a signature is really simple. All you have to do is come down and click the plus button. Give that signature a name. I'm going to call this one Basic. Over to the right side, you can adjust the information that shows up. You can add a different email address if you like. You can add your phone number or any other information you want. You can even open up your Finder and grab a picture and drag that picture right into the signature just like that. You can also change the font, color, and size of any text, but don't do it by clicking this font and color button. That's not where you do it. First, select the text you want, and then come up to the format menu and show fonts, which you can also do by pressing Command and T. And that will bring up your text screen, which will allow you to change the font to anything you want, change the size to anything you want, and even change the color to anything you want so you can customize it and make it look exactly like what you want it to look like. Once you've created your signature, the next step is assigning it to one of your accounts. You can have a signature on every account or only on specific accounts. What you'll do is drag it to each account you want to use it in. When you're ready to use it, click on that account. Down at the bottom, you can choose any of the signatures in that account, or you can set it up to choose one at random or in sequential order. In this case, I'm going to choose the basic one. Now, whenever I come in to create a new message, which you can do by clicking on the toolbar here, it immediately opens it up with that created signature. I can change to the other signatures by clicking here, or I can set it to no signature, or leave it on our basic signature. Keep in mind that because there is an image in our signature, the image size button over here can affect it. So if you see your signature come out with your picture being really large like this, don't panic. Just come over to the image size section and knock it down to small. There are other ways to create signatures that don't show as attachments and don't vary like that, but we're going to save that for a future episode. Up at the top, you're going to notice the paper airplane that will let you send this message. But to the right of that is a little drop-down menu that will allow you to send that message at a later point. So you can say send now, or tonight, or you can specify to send it anytime you want. When you do send your message, you can undo your send within 30 seconds of sending it, and it works like this. When you click the send button here, in the lower left-hand corner, you'll see that undo send right there. Clicking it will allow you to bring that message back in case you forgot to add an attachment or didn't mean to send it yet. You can customize how long the send later delay lasts by coming up to the mail menu and settings and going over into composing. You'll see that you can choose between turning it off, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, or 30 seconds. And now I'm going to step into one of my favorite tools that exists in MacMail. But before I do, let's take a moment. If you're getting some good value and you've learned something new about MacMail, go down to the comments section, tell me what you learned, tell me what you'd like to learn, and hit that thumbs up button so that other people can find this video easily. And while you're down there, take a moment and hit that subscribe button and that notify bell so you'll always be notified whenever I drop new content. And with that being said, let's move on to the next tip. Data recognition is one of my favorite and most used functionalities of MacMail. So when you have an email like this that is showing a date, an address, or a phone number, data recognition can help you take that information and put it into the right place. So if I come here and I highlight where it's got this date and I click that arrow, it's going to open up my calendar and allow me to create an event in my calendar right here. And I can change the name or any other information I want. And you'll notice it even added the address because the address was there. In addition to that, if this address is something that I need to add to my contacts, I can click the arrow here and either get directions there or add it right directly into my contacts. Down here, when you see a phone number, I can click that, I can add it to my contacts, or I can text message or FaceTime that person right from there. So I highly recommend you play around with data recognition the next time you've got an email with a date, an address, or a phone number to add to your calendar or to update your address book so that all of your information is synced up and accurate. To create a reminder, all you have to do is right-click on a message, come down to Remind Me, and set a time or a specific day. In this case, I'm just gonna set this for a couple of minutes from now and schedule it. When something is set as a reminder, you'll notice the little Remind Me section shows up right at the top of it, and it brings it up to the front of your email account. In addition to that, by clicking on the Remind Me section on the left, you can pull any of those messages in to make it easy for you to find the messages that you need to address and need to take care of. Searching is a really, really valuable component of MacMail, and it's necessary, but a lot of people don't really understand how to use the search tool properly. So I'm going to click in the search bar, and I'm just going to type in a couple of letters. Now, when I do that, it pulls up a contact as well as the specific email of that contact. It also gives me the ability to choose a subject or an attachment with those letters in them. In this case, I'm going to pick the contact, which shows me everything from Thomas Thurman. But I can also click this little button here to change it to everything to Thomas Thurmond, or to everything that has the word Thomas Thurmond in the message itself. I can come over and I can add additional criteria. As it brings this up, I can choose subject, which again will mean that the subject Dylan is there, or that the word Dylan is somewhere in that email. And by using search this way, you can really find things quickly. On the left side, you need to recognize where you're searching. If you're clicked on all mailboxes, it's going to search everywhere. But if you know that message is in a specific email, you can come directly to that mailbox and just search there so you're not overwhelmed by all of the results you get. So between being more specific with how you use the search and being more clear of which mailbox it's searching, you can find anything easily. And when you're done with a search, just click the little X in the upper right corner and that search will disappear and return you back to your normal mailbox. Which brings us to my power tip. One of the things I get asked the most frequently about MacMail is how do I make it stop autofilling the wrong address? Autofill happens from a couple of different locations. The first place it's looking for it is in your address book. So your first thing to do is to search the address book to see if that incorrect email is there. If it's there, delete it from the address book. But the second step is more important, and it's a tool that's hiding under the window menu called Previous Recipients. And Previous Recipients is a super valuable tool. When you click on Previous Recipients, it's going to give you a list of everybody you've sent an email to. And within here, you can sort it by when you last sent them the message, which is a great way to clear out emails of people you're not really messaging that frequently. You can sort it by the email, or you can sort it by the name. And even better, you can sort it by whether that person is in your address book or not. You see, if you've got this little contact icon on the left, it means that it's found an exact match to that contact in your address book. So if you see someone you communicate with all the time that isn't in that address book, you can add them by just clicking Add to Contacts, and immediately their address will get added into your list so that in the future you have it. Remember, the memory of who you've emailed doesn't synchronize, so if you don't have it in your address book and you go to another device, it may not show up properly. And the previous recipients can also be used for you to do a quick search of that specific name, click on it, and remove it from the list so that it stops autofilling with that information. So that's what we've got for today's lesson. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer, and it's my passion and profession to help you get more done with your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And I will see you next time.